What's up, Navigating Academia family? I hope you guys are having a great week so far. I just have a viewer question that I want to respond to with all of you today. I thought this was a great question. You know, I find myself for the last several viewer questions focusing a lot about getting into grad school and these sorts of things. So I had a question from somebody who's interested in doing a postdoctoral fellowship. And so I figured that that would be kind of a nice change of pace for people. Even if it's something where right now you're still applying to grad school and all, then I hope you will consider doing a postdoc one day. So this could be relevant to you too, so be sure to stick around. Make sure to do me a big favor and like this video. It helps with the YouTube algorithm. Make sure to leave a comment below, especially if you have a question that you think would be relevant to the entire population of Navigating Academia viewers, all several thousand of us. I love you guys so much. You mean the world to me. Please keep asking questions. This has just been fantastic. And the view rates on the viewer response videos have been so surprising to me. They're like the best ones in terms of like the speed of viewers. And also, it really means a lot to me. So thank you very much. Okay, and if you haven't subscribed, obviously subscribe to the channel. We're awesome. We're awesome people on this channel. So, okay, here we go. Here's questions from Anu. Anu says, I believe that doing a postdoc will improve my publication record, but to get a postdoc opportunity, how do I contact the professor? If I do contact them, how do I inconvenience them because I don't have a good publication record after doing my PhD. I've migrated to Canada very recently from India, and I'm very confused about what to do. Please help. So Anu, thank you so much for your question. This is definitely one where I think it's a challenge for a lot of people who, you know, during their doctorate, you know, what the peer-reviewed literature says is that in terms of individuals who went and did a doctoral dissertation, that the number one predictor of if they have publications and how many they have is whether or not they had a strong supportive mentor who made it kind of known that, you know, there was an expectation to publish. It wasn't like, oh, maybe you can publish, maybe you should publish. No, it was basically, you're going to publish. This is how many things you're going to publish. This is when it's going to happen. You need to have these things done by these dates. Because sometimes, especially when we're in graduate school and we're new to academia, we need a strong mentor in our life to be able to kind of place these challenges in front of us so that then we can go and tackle them, right? And we need somebody to encourage us. As a lot of you know, grad school can be a time where it's just not a lot of support. I was talking to a colleague of mine yesterday in Nevada. She's finishing up her doctorate in criminology. And I was telling her about like the one person when I was doing my doctorate who was the most supportive guy ever. And he was a Swedish psychologist. And it just like meant the world to me. He was just so nice. And he was like the one person who was super nice to me. So you guys know how much that can mean if you're still in grad school right now, or if you've just finished, or if you're de-traumatized enough to look back on your doctoral experience and smile. But basically, if that wasn't the case for you, right, and that happens, if that's the case, the good news is you've got your doctoral dissertation, and the doctoral dissertation can be cannibalized in a number of different ways. Usually, no matter where you are, you've got a general introduction, a general discussion section. The intro, whether it's just chapter one or chapter one and chapter two, which would be U.S. System Lit Review. My recommendation is you take that first bit and then you publish it as an edited book chapter, because you can go really deep in depth. And, you know, that's usually what a lit review is. Some journals, even there's a BMC journal called Virology Journal, which even has a system where you can submit it. I think that's just awesome of them. And then also in terms of the discussion section, usually you've got a lot of forward thinking things. I recommend publishing that as a thought leadership piece, which could be something like an editorial, for example, instead of a formal peer reviewed article. It could also be like a commentary. So that's what I recommend on that front. And then you've got kind of like your study or multiple studies. That's kind of in the middle. So the likelihood is very high that even if you haven't published anything yet, that you can come up with a solid publication plan on it. And that's what I recommend to you, is to be able to really take the time. And before, this is before you get in touch with your target professor, who would be the supervisor, right? And usually it's a lot more rare that, you know, a given professor will like just have a constant stream of postdocs and these things. Usually, you know, maybe everybody's got two or three grad students, but there'll be like two or three postdocs in the whole department, right? Like, that's it. And that's usually because they're fully funded, right? So like for me, I made $40,000 US dollars back when I did my postdoc, which was about 10 years ago, 9, 10 years ago. Which is great. It doesn't feel like that, but it is. I had hair, my glorious hair. I actually like being bald though. But it's one of those things, right? So it's a while ago now. It's like 10 years. And it was a great time. I love my postdoc. I really recommend everybody does a postdoc. It's a great idea and a great experience, especially if you got good mentors. Before you contact them, I want you to come up, and usually this is something you have to do anyway in the first several months of your postdoc, a publication plan. And it doesn't just have to be publications. It can be, okay, like these are the manuscripts that I want to cannibalize out of my doctoral dissertation. Maybe you have a master's thesis project, you never published that, but it's only a few years old, so the data is still relatively fresh. And you want to, they call it publish before it perishes, rather than publish before perish. What is it? Guys, I'm so exhausted, right? Publish or perish, damn it. Okay, so publish before it perishes instead of publish or perish. That's the idea. And you want it, why? Because the field changes. There's 1.5 million articles published every single year across fields, and that's consistent for the last 10 years. So the literature comes so quick, and it takes an average of 17 years for 14 frickin' percent of the literature to get translated into practice. So it's nuts. Like, the odds of you publishing something that actually has an impact on day-to-day is exceptionally low. And it's really important that, you know, you throw your hat, your proverbial hat, into the ring to be somebody who hopefully can publish at least one thing or whatever that actually drills down and makes a difference. I mean, that's why we do this, right? That's why we do research. And that's why we publish. So come up with that publication plan. Also think about awards you want to apply for leading associations. Think about conferences that you want to go to. Try to build social capital through things like symposia, maybe a special issue, anything where you can build up that social currency, right? Through networking is incredibly important, right? Have a solid game plan. Think about like being an entrepreneur and you want to raise money, let's say, right? Well, you can't just go or whatever and be like, I want to raise money. And they're like, what for? And they're like, well, you know, I got some ideas. No, you need a solid business plan that you need to bring to investors. Same thing here, right? That's kind of like an investor. They're going to be investing in you, the postdoc supervisor. So it's really important that you spend that time and you figure out, okay, this is kind of my game plan and I need assistance in executing. And I think you're amazing and I would love for you to be my supervisor, right? That's the idea. And remember that the nature of the relationship will be different because they're not a supervisor like in the grad school sense. In the grad school sense, it was not a collegial, come on. For most of us, that was not a collegial situation. Now this is going to start being a collegial situation. And to be honest with you, it can be really uncomfortable at the very beginning. I remember my postdoc supervisor, this awesome guy, and he took me to the equivalent of Subway in Florida. It's called the Pita Pit. The Pita Pit. And I remember sitting there, and this guy's like my hero, right? And I'm like sitting there or whatever with this guy at the Pita Pit. And I'm like, what is my life? Like, this is the weirdest thing. And, you know, he was very generous with me always. So, you know, bless him. Just a great guy. And so I really lucked out on that one. But have that plan, especially if you don't have a lot of publications yet. And obviously, if you're not in a rush, it's a really good idea to like write some of those things up for publication and submit them out and get them published. Make sure that they're not in predatory journals, high impact as possible. My recommendation is that you shoot for a journal that's one standard deviation in terms of its impact factor above what you think it'll probably most likely get published in, because sometimes you get pleasantly surprised. Anybody who doesn't know how to publish, whether you're an undergrad, grad student, early career professional, I have been working my tail off through all of 2020 to develop an over 120-hour training program on exactly how to publish. It's the greatest thing that I've ever made, and without a doubt, the most comprehensive training that has literally ever been built. And so I'm really, really excited about it. I've done it with colleagues from Harvard, Oxford, Cambridge, Smithsonian, PBS, Discovery Channel, and NASA. So we just got the absolute best people on it. And I'm really thrilled. That'll be coming out in January 2021. And so if you're watching this beyond that, it's already out. So make sure you check it out. It's going to be great. And if you're interested in one-on-one consultation with me, please always feel free to sign up for a paid session. I would love to be able to work with you one-on-one. So God bless you. Have a wonderful day. Peace.